The genitive absolute is the subject of this video to go with Hansen and Quinn's Greek, an intensive course, and they cover the subject on pages 322 to 323. So to learn about genitive absolute, let's remember a little bit about circumstantial participles, because really genitive absolute is a specialized version of a circumstantial participle. When we've done them before, for instance, in this sentence, thuon hohiareus hupa tu demu timatai, the participle here in brown agrees with whatever noun in the sentence is doing that participle. So here, that nominative singular participle is agreeing with the priest, and the sentence means when he sacrifices, the priest is honored by the people. We could do that in a more default way, sacrificing, the priest is honored by the people. And of course, circumstantial participles can have lots of different relationships with the main clause. I chose temporal here, when he sacrifices, the priest is honored by the people. And I use the fact that thuon agrees with hohiereus to turn that into a whole clause in English, temporal clause, when he sacrifices, and the he is the priest. The participle is nominative, and it agrees with the nominative in the main clause of the sentence. Another example would be sosasi tein polin tois tha ois thuomen. Since they saved the city, we sacrifice to the gods. Here, the participle is agreeing with tois theois. They're both dative. The main clause is tois theois thuomen, we sacrifice to the gods. The participial phrase sosasin tein polin agrees with those gods and tells us who's doing or who did the saving. And so we get, since they saved the city, we sacrifice to the gods. But what would happen in a sentence like this? Since the gods saved the city, we danced all night. Well, the main clause is simple, echorelsamen pasantein nukta. But if we want to turn the subordinate clause, since the gods saved the city, into a participial phrase, which we know the Greeks really like to do, it's a little bit tricky. The only people or things in the main clause are we as part of the verb, and the night as part of the accusative extent of time. But there's nothing in the main clause for the participial phrase or the participle to agree with. We're not involved with the saving, and neither is the night. So this is where genitive absolute comes in. The fact that the participle has nothing to agree with in the main clause is actually why this is called a genitive absolute. It exists independently of the syntax of the rest of the sentence. It's all on its own. It's absolute. And what we can do is use the formula for genitive absolute, which is a genitive noun plus a participle that agrees with it in the genitive. And the default translation is with the noun verbing, or if perhaps the verb is passive, with the noun being verbed. And of course, there are middle translations as well. And so with our sentence here, we would take the gods and put them in the genitive and make the participle agree with them in the genitive. And so what we get is ton theon tein polin sosan ton. There's the genitive noun ton theon and the genitive participle that agrees with it. And that means now, along with our main clause in Greek, echerelsamen pasantein nukta, it means with the gods saving the city, we danced all night, which is a very good translation into Greek of since the gods saved the city, we danced all night. Here's another example. Tes polios sotheses hoi hiores ethusan. With the city saved, the priest sacrificed. So there again, you see the genitive noun tes polios with a genitive participle to agree with it, so theses. And we can do the default translation with the noun being verbed, with the city saved, because it's an aorist participle here, the priests sacrificed. There's nothing in the main clause for that participle to agree with. So we see that in the subordinate phrase, the participial phrase, what's doing the participle still agrees with it, which is our rule for participles, and we can translate it with the city saved, the priest sacrificed. But we can also translate it in any of the other ways that we translate circumstantial participles in English. So it could be temporal, when the city was saved, the priest sacrificed, or although the city was saved, the priests sacrificed, or because the city was saved, the priest sacrificed. All of these, as you know, are good translations of circumstantial participles depending on your context. And the negative for any of those would be ooh. Now, there is one translation of circumstantial participles that would take a may as a negative, and that's if it were a conditional participle. So in this instance, we're going to know that that's true. Tes poleos me sotheses, so almost the same participial phrase, with the city not being saved, ou thousomen, we will not sacrifice. And that is the same as saying, if the city is not saved, we will not sacrifice. And I know that it's the if version, the conditional version, because of the negative may. You don't have to have a negative to know that it's a conditional circumstantial participle. But if you do, you know for sure that it is, because that's the only kind that has a may. And that'll get you started with the genitive absolute. It's one of those things, as everything else is in Greek, that makes more and more sense the more that you use it. So practice with the sentences and the drills and enjoy.